Yo, what is up, everybody? Jumpin here, and today I want to talk about the new patch coming out for Dark Souls 2. This will be released with the Scholar of the First Sin, the new re-release of the game for the PlayStation 4, Xbox One, Xbox 360, and PS3, and I guess the PC as well. But they have decided to change a lot of things, and this list is really long. I will actually put a link in the description if you want to go and check out this list for yourself. I'm not going to talk about everything, only things that I deem important and I think needs to be talked about. Now, in the background, this will actually be an episode of my no-hug run, but I cannot commentate it and this at the same time. I'll get too distracted, so this is a post-commentary, and I really just want to break this down and tell you what I feel when it comes to the new patch, because there's some good, and there is some bad, and we need to talk about it. Alright, so let's go ahead and start to break this down. Now, the very first thing might seem like a minor thing. By the way, there are plenty of minor things on this list that I do not feel I need to mention. Some of these problems I didn't even know existed in the game, but props to FromSoft for fixing all these problems, because if it has affected players, I'm sure it pissed them off, and it's nice to just get rid of any problem that they know of. Now, the first thing here might seem like a minor thing, but to me, I actually feel like this is somewhat important. Basically, what they're going to do is that they're going to add additional description text to items. I think that's great. The reason why is because in Dark Souls, the lore was amazing. And there was a ton of people making videos talking about the lore, speculating about some things, and really just explaining other things. Now, I am not a lore guy. I don't really read into it much, but I love to watch those videos and learn about the lore. I just don't want to do any of the work. But I have noticed that people don't really do that with Dark Souls 2. I'm sure there's some people out there who they do that. But overall, it's very minor compared to how much people were just doing it with Dark Souls. Now, to me, there's two reasons for this. A, the lore just sucks dick. Could be that. The lore is just horrible in Dark Souls 2, and nobody really wants to talk about it because it sucks. Maybe that's what it is, but I doubt it. Or it could just be that it's really cryptic, and there's not enough information to really, like, understand the lore fully and to really have some, like, facts to back up statements. So people just don't want to make those videos because the lore isn't as in-depth as it was in Dark Souls. I think it's the latter. So it would be nice for them to go ahead and extend some of the descriptions and to really help people understand the world and the lore. And a lot of people will probably start making more videos if they can really have a better understanding of the lore in general. Alrighty, now the next thing that I want to talk about, I think this is a good change as well. It at least will give players the choice, which I always think is better to at least have a choice in certain matters, because this was a really big problem for a lot of people. Now, personally, I never really cared all that much about this, but I know a lot of people complained about it. What they're going to do is they're going to make it so that if you join the Covenant of Champions, enemies will always respawn. If you kill an enemy too many times, as it is right now, they will stop respawning. And a lot of people complain that, A, it really sucks if you're trying to farm something. That is so true. Because then you have to go and burn a bonfire aesthetic, you have to maybe go fight the boss again, and the enemies are just getting stronger and stronger and stronger, and it gets really annoying. So that is nice. But a lot of players will complain and say, that's not Dark Souls. Dark Souls is all about giving you a challenge before you fight the boss, and then giving you a challenge when you fight the boss. And I can definitely say that is the truth. Like, at least with Dark Souls, some areas were a fucking nightmare. The enemies just suck. Now, yes, you could run past all the enemies, but for your first playthrough, you might not do that, because you don't really know how to run past enemies effectively. So instead, you're going to be forced to really fight those enemies. And those enemies can kick your ass. Well, the thing is that if you're stuck on a boss, then what will happen is that you'll kill those enemies, and then eventually you don't have to worry about those enemies anymore, because they will stop respawning. And people said that takes away from the game, because the game is supposed to be hard up to the boss, and then the boss is supposed to be hard as well. So, at least this will give players the option to not have that happen. But, it still won't really change anything. I seriously doubt people are going to join the Covenant of Champions, unless they don't know what it does, which is the case for a lot of new players. They just join it because it's there. They don't realize it's going to make the game harder. And this will definitely make the game harder for beginners. But I think overall, it is a good change. Now, the real question though, what about things like the Katarina set or the Monastery set? Will this affect that? I doubt it, but I hope that they will at least understand that is something that they might want to do, because that is a big complaint. It is really annoying farming for the Katarina set or for the Monastery set. So it would be nice to say, hey, I'm going to go farm for this. I'm going to go and join the Covenant of Champions. It's going to make the game harder, but I will be able to keep farming this NPC and try to get the drop that I want. So overall, I do think that is a very good change. Alright, so now it's time to get into the bad. Now this is probably the worst thing on the entire list, and I don't know, there's a lot of bad things on this list, but let me actually rephrase that. Let me say there's a lot of things on this list that I'm worried about. Because this might not be all that bad. This actually might be really good. Because I haven't experienced it yet, I can't really say that this is horrible and the worst thing ever, because I really don't know. But I am worried. I am really worried about this. I think this sounds stupid. Maybe the way that they're describing it is just stupid. Could be a possibility. But I think this is ridiculous. Now, when I first heard about this list, I was like, okay, I'm going to go and check that out later. Then someone came and said, Jumpin, they're removing Soul Memory. And I was like, bing! I hate Soul Memory. I have made videos about that. I have bitched in so many videos about that. I'm not going to get into the whole reason why Soul Memory sucks, or at least why I hate it so much. But I do not like the system. I prefer Soul Level. So when I heard that they were going to change Soul Memory or remove it, I was like, I have to go and see this. Now, the person who said this, I don't really think he thought about it, because basically, I don't think they're removing Soul Memory. Soul Memory will be the exact same, but they are adding something new. They're going to make it so that players will gain access to a special ring. And what will happen is that when you wear the ring and you kill players, instead of absorbing the souls yourself, the ring will absorb the souls. So basically, this ring will be like a soul memory ring. Now, if you remove the ring, I'm sure soul memory will work normally, the way it has always worked. But if you have the ring on, it's not going to work that way. Now, you might say, why is this so bad? You have to understand, why do we have soul memory? Why did they change the system? The main reason why they changed it was to protect low-level players. Players that were brand new, totally beginners, just starting the game. One of the biggest complaints in the original Dark Souls was that a player who had some experience, now you could do it legitimately, or you could be a dirty cheater and just mod, which a lot of people did, but it was possible to do this legitimately, where you could be a low-level and go ahead and beat the game or get really far in the game as a low level, max out your gear, max weapon, armor, pyromancy flame, and then you could go and invade low level beginners who don't even know what they're doing and just one shot them with great combustion. This was something that you could do. They went ahead and said, well, that is a big problem. Players can do this and they can mod their save on top of it, and they don't even have to do any work to do this. So let's go ahead and introduce a system that will protect the low-level players from these people. So they went ahead and they did that. But here's the problem. Soul Memory really starts to be an issue at the higher levels, NG+. Once you get to like 15 million Soul Memory, the whole system just totally collapses on itself, because you are almost forced to level up. If you don't level up, you are putting yourself at a disadvantage. Most people are high level, and you are choosing to remain a low level, then you are going to be, unfortunately, hit hard by Soul Memory. Because you'll constantly be invaded by high level people, and you'll constantly invade high level people. I have no problem with invading high-level people. I have a problem with being invaded by high-level people. Now this ring, if this allows me to control my soul memory, or at least to have a separate soul memory, I think players are going to exploit this shit. I mean, unless they really restrict it, and they come up with different rules and different things that you could do with this ring to make it so that the low-level players will be protected, it's gonna be chaos. Those low-level players, those beginners, are gonna get destroyed. People are going to exploit the shit out of this, potentially. Like I said, I'm not 100%. I don't know how this is gonna work. But if that is how it works, I mean, it just doesn't make any sense. Do we want to protect the low-level players, or do we not want to protect the low-level players? It's called a contradiction. I don't get it. I don't get it. Anyway, there's some things that they could do to maybe lessen this effect. The first thing is, maybe the ring won't even really work until you get 1 million soul memory on the ring. Then it works. That will protect low-level people, beginners. Okay, that's fine. But still, just the idea that I could be max level and I can invade people that are going to be way lower level than me is still fucking frustrating. I think what they should have done with this ring, what would be so much better, is you come out with a ring that's kind of like the name engraved ring. When you put it on, you have a choice. And your choice could be like this. You could set the range of the soul level that you want to PvP against and have a minimum and a maximum. But that will allow players to have a meta. There could be a meta with a ring like that. Because if you want to be a part of the meta, just put the ring on. And when I have the ring on, I can't be ridiculously overleveled. And they can't be ridiculously overleveled either. Instead, we're getting a fucking soul memory ring. What the fuck? What's the point of that? That doesn't make any sense. We already have soul memory. We don't need a fucking ring. Especially when you could just take the ring off. You're telling me that I can build up, let's say, 500,000 soul memory on this ring. So I can only PvP against people that are in that range of 500,000 soul memory. Then when I invade them, can I take the ring off? So that when I kill them, I'm not going to get any souls added to the ring? I mean, how's that fair? Now, maybe they could make it so that you always have to wear the ring. I evade someone, I have the ring on, I can't take it off. Or if I have it on and someone evades me, I can't take it off. I have to keep it on. That way you can't cheese it. You know, you can't, like, cheat or exploit the system. But still, I seriously doubt they're going to make it like that. I just don't know why they're doing this. I just feel like unless they come up with different things to restrict it, the low-level players are going to be exploited. They're going to be destroyed by high-level players. And that's just not fucking cool. I'm all for the idea of protecting beginners. Because the last thing you want to do in any game, I think, is to have people who don't know what they're doing and they're just trying out a game. They're like, oh, Dark Souls. I heard that's a fun game. It's supposed to be a hard game. Let me go try that. They get on Dark Souls. And then, boom, they're getting trashed by all these high-level players. They can't do shit. And then they're basically like, fuck this game, man. This game fucking sucks. And they just give up on it. I like the idea of protecting those people. Because once they are at the right point, then they should be exposed to all of the chaos. But when they're just starting out, they shouldn't be exposed to that shit. So that's the worst thing on this list. And that's the thing I wanted to talk about the most. Let's go ahead and talk about a couple other things. So this next one sounds like a good thing, but I wanted to bring this up because in a way I kind of feel like this might be somewhat pointless, and I'll explain why. But it does sound good. I like the sound of it. Anyway, so this is what it says. When you are in your bonfire warp selection screen, they will highlight three areas that will have like the most players that you're able to connect with. So at first you hear that, you're like, oh, that's great. Because now I'll know if I'm in a certain area and there's barely anyone here and it's hard for me to get a game, I'll know ahead of time. I won't invade in that area. I'll go somewhere else. Problem is, I feel like no matter what, the three areas that will always be highlighted will be Hyde's Tower, the Iron Keep, Forest of the Fallen Giants. That is where people PvP primarily. I don't know if there's really a point of this, only because more than likely, if the majority of people PvPing are going to be in those areas, then those areas will probably always be the areas that are highlighted for you. Alright, so the next thing once again, I'm like 50-50 on this one. This could be kind of bad, but this is also like whatever to me. I'm not like too worried about it. But what they're going to do is they're going to make it so that white phantoms will remain in other players' worlds for longer periods of time. Now, right now, I got to be honest, I thought white phantoms remained in the world long enough. Like, they're in there a long time, okay? Now, if you're talking about shades, that's a different story. Shades could maybe use a buff. They could stay in the world a little bit longer. I'm okay with that. But white phantoms? Really? Like, do we really need to increase the time? What is this for? Gankers? Like, are they trying to help gankers out? Because that's all I can see with this. This is just gonna make ganking even better. Because now those white phantoms can stay in the world longer. That's fucking dumb, man. That is fucking dumb. Alright, moving on. This one is fucking ridiculous. Now, this could go one of two ways. If it goes the first way, I'm okay with it. I am perfectly okay with this. If it goes the second way, I am fucking totally against this. Now, this is what it says. Players on their first playthrough can now match with players on their second or further playthroughs. Now, the first way that could go, which I'm okay with. If I'm on my first playthrough and I want to PvP and I want to try to invade players, I'm okay with the idea of invading people on, like, let's say their 10th playthrough and them being higher level than me. That's alright, because I'm the invader, and if you're going to be an invader, you have to have that mindset. I'm invading someone else's world. I don't know what to expect. Could be someone just trying to beat the boss. Could be an ambush. It could be me getting ganked. They might be max level. That's fine, because that is how you have to go into it as an invader. But I'm not okay with the idea of higher level people or max level people are people that are on NG plus 10 invading people that are low level. I'm not okay with that. Once again, it goes right back to Soul Memory, why it sucks. It's all about the idea that that can happen. You're telling me that if I'm on NG plus 10 max level, I can invade someone on their very first playthrough, and if I have that one fucking stupid Soul Memory ring maybe, I can invade them if they're really low level? Like, whoa, that's fucking fair. No, it's not. So hopefully it is the first way, where only if you are choosing to invade players, you can invade people in other playthroughs. But it shouldn't be the other way around. That is not cool. We do need to protect the beginners. Alright, so that's one of the worst things, I think. This one is just really confusing. I'm not sure what they mean by this. I really feel like the wording of some of this stuff doesn't really make much sense. But I'll go ahead and read this, and you tell me, what does this mean? I added this on my list just because I didn't know what this meant, and I was hoping you guys could explain it. This is what it says. Made it so that invading players cannot use items which invite more enemies. What the fuck does that mean? When I first read this, I was thinking, are they talking about like seeds or something? But they say, made it so invading players, not the host, only the host can see, cannot use items which invite more enemies. I don't really know of items like that. Are there items that will make more enemies spawn once you invade people? I don't think so. Are they talking about like alluring skulls maybe? Like, can I go ahead and like get the enemies to follow me or something? I'm not too sure, so it's really confusing. Maybe you guys could explain that to me, whatever that means. But let's just talk about Seeds of a Giant for a second. You know, one of the things with this whole re-release, if they're going to bring the game back out, I think what they should do, or what they should have done, is actually go into the game and try to fix some of the problems. And one of the problems would be something like Seeds of the Giant. Now, yes, Seeds of the Giant, they were fun for a while. But people can mod that shit, man. People can duplicate that shit. Get it out the game. It's unfucking fair. Like, why introduce an item that you can potentially cheat with? That's just not fucking smart. That's not good game design. So if I could have it my way, I would just go in there and say, listen, seeds were fun for a while, but let's just take them out the game. Because people are going to just exploit these things. So fuck it. I think that would be better. But they're not doing that. Alright, now this one is actually really good. I really love this change. What they're going to do is they're going to make it so that you can choose to cancel the effect of a human effigy at a bonfire. If you choose to burn a human effigy at a bonfire, it makes it so that you cannot play online at all. You cannot be invaded. You cannot do co-op. Now, there's certain areas that that's actually a really good idea at. But when you do that, it's fucking annoying because it lasts for fucking ever. I don't know if it, like, wears off. I guess it does. I kind of think it does. But it does last a really long time. So now, you can just choose to turn that off. You put it on, you can turn it off whenever you want. That is great. Thank God for that. So if you're trying to farm or if you're trying to do something in an area, you don't want to be invaded, burn a human effigy, and then when you're ready to go back online in that area, go ahead and take the effect off and problem solved. Now this one might seem pretty trivial, might seem like it's a minor thing, but I just want to mention it because I feel like it's so annoying. It's happened to me so many times, and I'm sure it's happened to a lot of players, and I'm glad they're changing this. When you're on your first playthrough, when you beat the boss, you have to watch the credits. But then, if you burn a bonfire aesthetic, and you want to beat the boss again to farm for souls, or whatever it might be, you have to watch the credits again. You cannot skip it. On NG Plus, you can, but on your first playthrough, no matter how many times you fight the boss, you can fight that boss 10 times. You have to watch those credits all 10 times. You cannot skip it. Really annoying. So what they're going to do is, once you watch the credits once, you can skip it. Even on your first playthrough. I like that just because it's going to save me a lot of time. And it's just an annoying thing you have to put up with. I fucking cannot stand that. Alright, so let's talk about another thing that's really fucking bad. Now, there were some things in Dark Souls 2 that they changed from Dark Souls that were good changes. And I have talked about this one because I think this is a great change. But for whatever reason, they're changing it back. And I don't know of anyone who has ever really complained about this. Maybe some people have, but I've never met a person that's ever bitched about this. So I don't know why they're changing this. What they're gonna do is that they're going to prevent you from being invaded after a boss is dead. Now, that might not sound like a big deal, but wait a minute. That is a fucking huge deal, because it was so fucking annoying in the first game. If you beat the boss, you can't PvP in that area. Now, in the first game, they didn't have bonfire aesthetics. In this game, they do. So, you can, of course, just burn a bonfire aesthetic and PvP in that area. But it's still dumb. You're telling me that at the Iron Keep, I have to either beat the smelter, move on, and then go and burn a bonfire aesthetic, or I have to skip the smelter if I want to PvP? What? Why can't I just beat the smelter and then just PvP? That's fine. That's a good change. You know, one of the biggest problems with Dark Souls was that there was a lot of areas that were awesome areas, amazing areas. But you could not PvP in those areas because there were no bosses in that area. A great example is Ash Lake. It was a giant beach. It was beautiful. It would be amazing to have a fight club there. Couldn't do it though. So my question is, if they're going to make it so that you cannot be invaded once the boss is dead, and you can also not do co-op either, by the way, but if they're going to make it like that, does that mean that if there's an area that doesn't have a boss, I can't be invaded? Are you serious? Like, that's some BS, because there's gonna be areas that you're gonna want to PvP in just because it might be a cool area and there's no boss. So I hope they don't change that, but it's fucking stupid. Like, why change that at all? I don't think people complain about that. I really don't. Basically, what it says is that it's going to apply the human effigy effect, which totally cuts you off of, like, the online world. So, yes, that means no red phantom signs, no dragon signs, no white signs, no shades, no random invasions at all once the boss is dead. Fucking stupid, man. I don't know why they're changing that. Alright, so the final thing they're doing that I want to talk about is that they're going to actually change the reward system for, like, invading people or being a host and killing invaders. Now, the way they word this can be a little confusing, so I'm going to just change it up so that everyone can understand. Basically, if you are a host and you kill either a red phantom or a blue phantom, you will be rewarded a human effigy. That is nice. That is really nice. In the first game, if you killed the invader, you would get a humanity. Now you will get a human effigy. I like that. The next one is, if you summon a red phantom and you win, then you will get a human effigy. That is awesome. This one is probably the best, though. I really love this. If you go into a bell tower and you're fighting against the bell bros, every time you win, you'll be rewarded either a titanite chunk, titanite slab, twinkling titanite, or dragon bone. That's going to make farming for twinkling titanite and dragon bones much easier. Because if you just need some twinkling titanite or dragon bones, go in PvP in the bell tower and you will get some twinkling titanite and some dragon bones. Now this one's not a big deal, but if you are in like a rat area, I guess if you're a host, then you will, if you kill someone who invades you, you will get a smooth and silky stone and you will get a lock stone. So that will be your reward. All right, blue sentinels. Now this is freaking stupid. The change is good, but the fact that this did not exist before was dumb. I did not know this. But if you are a blue sentinel and you kill a dark phantom that is attacking a host, you know how that works, where I think you have to be in the way of the blue, you wear that ring. If you get invaded, a blue sentinel can come and save the day. Well, if you're that blue sentinel and you kill that red invader, you will be rewarded with +1 devotion to the Blue Sentinel Covenant. But wait a minute, you're telling me that all this time, you never got devotion for that? You got nothing out of that? What's the point of doing that then? See, I always thought you got devotion. I didn't realize you got no devotion for that. That is fucking stupid. That is so dumb. Now, if you are a Rat King Invader, and you kill the host, you will be rewarded with a smooth and silky stone and a lock stone, just like if you're the host. Same with the bell bros. If you are a bell bro and you invade a host, you will be rewarded with either a titanite chunk, titanite slab, twinkling titanite, or a dragon bone. So that is freaking epic. I think before it was just titanite chunks, which was good, but I would much rather get twinkling titanite. Now, if you are in the Abyss Covenant, and I guess if you're a host and you kill an invader, you will be rewarded. This is confusing, but it says, added human effigy to bonfire aesthetic. Does that mean you get a human effigy and a bonfire aesthetic? Or does it mean either you get a human effigy or a bonfire aesthetic? I don't know. The wording of some of this stuff makes no fucking sense. I'm assuming that these were all translated from Japanese, and some of it is just like a little bit like off because the wording just doesn't make no sense there. Human effigy to bonfire aesthetic. Anyway, final one. This is the best one. Because I made a video about this. Oh boy, I fucking hate the Brotherhood of Blood so fucking much. I did a whole rant video about it. And I would say that half the people agreed with me and half the people didn't agree with me. And I'm going off of like the likes and dislikes. I think I have more likes than dislikes on that video. But I know I have a lot of dislikes and I have a lot of likes. Anyway, one of my big points in that video was how stupid it was with the Dueling Arena. The Dueling Arena was fucking dumb. And one of the big issues is that if you want to get rank 3 Brotherhood of Blood, you have to get 500 wins. Every time you're in the Dueling Arena and you lose, you get a -1. So it could take you like, I don't know, 1,000, 1,500 games to get rank 3 depending on how good you are. It might only take you, I don't know, 550 if you're really, really good and you never lose. But it was still really ridiculous. And on top of that, it takes so long to get a match in the Dueling Arena. Sometimes I sit there for like 10 minutes. And I get so bored. I'm like, fuck this shit. And I just go and invade people normally. But when you would invade people normally using the orbs, you would get nothing. Nothing. Nothing at all. Just souls, I guess. Now, when you do that, you invade with the orb, random people, you will get a +2 devotion to the Brotherhood of Blood. That is amazing. That means if you are doing random invasions, you will get rank 3 after 250 wins. And I don't think there's any like negatives for losing. So you just invade, 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 and eventually you'll get rank 3. I have killed so many people when I'm in the Brotherhood of Blood, using the orbs, invading randomly. I have never reached rank 1 in that coven. Never. Because I don't like the Dueling Arena. And I don't want to sit there doing the fucking Dueling Arena. That's dumb. So at least they're changing that. That is good. Overall, I will say that there are some changes here that I really like. But there are those changes that I'm not too sure about. There's some that I think are just flat out stupid, but when it comes to like the Soul Memory Ring, I guess I can't really say that it's like the worst thing ever, only because I haven't really experienced it yet. Don't really know what's up with that. But I do think that there's a lot of potential there for problems. A lot of players might exploit that system, and you might really, really hurt the players that might need to be protected. Let's go ahead and talk about this. I would love to read you guys' comments and see what you have to say. I'm really worried about it overall, but we'll see. We'll see what happens. And I might have missed some things that could be somewhat important. So if you want to look through the list, if you see anything there that you're like, oh man, that is an amazing change, go ahead and say something. Or if you see something that you think is really bad and you're like, oh, that's a horrible change, go ahead and say something. Anyway, guys, I really hope you have enjoyed this. If you have, will you please like and favorite the video for me? Be sure to subscribe for future content. I really do hope that everyone has a very nice day. Peace!